Okay, let's turn our Bibles to Book of Acts. Acts chapter 28. We're going to look at one verse. Acts chapter 28. We're going to look at verse 15. Acts chapter 28, verse 15. Acts chapter 28, verse 15. The title of the message is Courage That Comes From Thanksgiving. Courage That Comes From Thanksgiving. Acts chapter 28, verse 15. The Bible says, And from thence, when the brethren heard of us, they came to meet us as far as Appii Forum and the three taverns, whom when Paul saw, he thanked God and took courage. Brother Jay, can you pray for the message?
Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for dying on the cross for us, shedding your precious blood to wash our sins away. And thank you for rising up after 3 days, proving yourself that you are and still is God. Thank you for being alive. Thank you for still working in sinners' hearts to save them. And for those who are saved, to convict us so that we could live a righteous Christian life. We ask you that you'll cover this place with your blood. We ask you that you'll build the preacher, fill him with your Holy Spirit. Let him speak with power, authority, and clarity, and with freedom. Open our hearts, minds, and ears to your word. Help us not to think or focus on other things, except to hear from you. We ask you that you'll receive all the glory and honor. We thank you and love you. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Courage that comes from Thanksgiving. In this day and age, you and I need courage because the world's getting worse and worse. And each day of your life, you face trials and you have pain and you have suffering. And in order to overcome all those troubles in your life, you need courage. You know, our famous Bible verses, you know, Dr. Ruckman always, when you ask him to, you know, sign your Bible, he had Joshua 1:8-9, right? The Bible says, This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success. Verse 9, and I'm pretty sure many of the people have this verse as their life verse or have it in their heart. Have not I commanded thee, be strong and of a good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee, whithersoever thou goest. Think about it. When you have the Lord, and he's going wherever you're going, you could have courage. The fight is of the Lord. Each daily, I mean daily fight that you do on a daily basis, that's a lot of daily. But you are fighting, not by yourself. The Lord God is fighting for you. As you know, when you're in a competition, or say you grew up in a bad neighborhood, like some of our brethren here, and you get into some fights, maybe at school, right? You're at the wrong crowd, and they're called gangs, right? Some of them are gangs, some of them are wannabes. You get your biggest courage when you know that people who's fighting with you are stronger than anybody else. Like, you could do whatever you want because you know you're not gonna lose. Same thing in sports competition. When you know that you have great teammates, you have courage because, say you're playing basketball and you have this big guy, big center, who's, you know, protecting the basket, right? He could block everything. And you could play best defense that you want or some kind of defense that you want. Or even like goalie, if you're playing soccer, If you know that your goalie is a great goalie, you could take some chances and you could go after the ball more. It just tells you that when you know and when you recognize you have great backup behind you, you could have courage. And as Christians, you could have best courage, if that's a term. You could have the biggest courage and you could have the most boldness. Why? Because you have Lord God with you and always backing you up. However, that courage does not come out unless you have thanksgiving heart. Being thankful literally means what? You're telling God that, you know, I am nothing. I'm humble before you, and I let you do everything for me. That's what little sense of being thankful is. You know, as they say, being thankful goes together with being humble, right? I have never seen a thankful person who was proud and full of arrogance, right? Usually, thankful people are humble people because they're gracious and they're grateful. You know, a kid is thankful, right? When you give them a candy and they're so happy to receive it, they're being thankful. You know, a kid is unthankful when they receive the candy and they throw it on the ground. Or they, you know, back at you, is this it, right? Or they have another handout, where's extra, right? And then you can see that that's being unthankful. In your Christian walk, it's same as well. When God gives you that everything you need, you should be thankful right there. However, because of your selfishness, you have other handout too. Like, where's the other stuff that I want? Now, God will provide all your need because he cares for you. But you and I always try to go to the extra step. God, you know, where's my other things? Then what happens is that when you are unthankful, you don't really have courage. Courage doesn't come to unthankful people, especially as a Christian. Joshua was able to be courageous. Moses was able to be courageous. And many of the apostles, disciples as well. Why? Because they were thankful that Lord was with them and Lord fought for them. Do you have that kind of same sentiment where whatever you do on a daily basis in your Christian walk, you rely upon the Lord always so that whatever life hits you with, whether it's financial pain, whether it's physical pain, whether it's mental pain, whether it's relationship pain, you have the boldness and courage to go on. You have a boldness and courage with thanksgiving, because God is one that behind everything. If God allowed to happen, are you going to be like complaining? You know, we see in book of Exodus, Israelites, you know, they were known. They're like just like you and me. When good things happen, you're thankful for just a little bit, and then you start complaining right away. You get too complacent, per se. You're in a discomfort stage. Let's turn our Bibles to Exodus chapter 16, verse 8. Exodus chapter 16, verse 8. You and I need to first get rid of this complaining heart, murmuring heart. Exodus chapter 16, verse 8. If you have any murmuring and complaining heart about anything in your life, you have to get right with the Lord. You have to confess your sins and get right with the Lord and be thankful for everything. Without it, without thanksgiving, courage won't come. Exodus chapter 16, verse 8, the Bible says, "And Moses said, this shall be when the Lord shall give you in the evening flesh to eat, and in the morning bread to the full. For that the Lord heareth your murmurings, which ye murmur against him. And what are we? Your murmurings are not against us, but against the Lord." When you constantly complain, literally Moses is saying that you're complaining to God, right? When when people are surrounding you, when God put people in your life, especially spiritual leaders, right? It could be your parents, and it's at church, you know, pastors, teachers, and leaders. And once you start complaining to them, you know, Bible says you're complaining against God who put them in their places. And think about that. Because as human beings, you tend to gravitate towards negative things, always. That's why people love gossiping. People love talking, you know, bad things about other people. Even as Christians, so-called Bible believers, who has King James Bible as their final authority, and who says, you know, you love God and your neighbors, your brethren. When good things happen to others, you feel jealous. You feel envious. I mean, that is very bad. When you should be happy, when you should be joyous, instead, you feel like, why didn't that happen to me? And you start complaining. You look at your life and you look at your heart. Are you that type of person? Do you feel like it should have been me? I think that is ridiculous. Especially if we are one body in Christ. Say if your hand gets clean, right? Because it's dirty. It was dirty. Do you think your left hand is going to be like jealous and envious? Or do you feel that your left hand and your left hand should be jealous of your right hand? That it's more cleaner now? Or for example, if you hurt your right hand, it got better. It got healed. Do you think your left hand should be jealous or be sad, you know, envious that your right hand actually got healed? Do you want your right hand to be, you know, under pain forever and ever and ever? No. Same thing. You really have to check your heart. It's all about your heart. I mean, do you have murmurings towards God about everything that's going on in your life? Do you have murmurings towards pastors and pastors' wives? Do you have murmurings towards teachers? Do you have murmuring towards, you know, everybody? You have murmuring towards about the air, about cars, about home, about everything. And think about it. At the end of the day, you're complaining towards God. You're murmuring towards God. And what's the end of people who murmur against God? They get destroyed. God does not want his children to be a murmurer or complainers. And when you are complaining and murmuring, there's no way you have courage to do things for God. Honestly, when we used to go out street preaching, you know, before pandemic and visitation, there's some days you have like more courage and boldness. And when you rewind and you think about it, why did I have that courage? Obviously, of course, you have love for the lost souls out there, right? You put God first, and you are really thankful that you had opportunity to street preach, and you had opportunity to do visitation. You could lead people to the Lord. Then, the Bible verse that says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me, you can really show in your conversation and in your life where your preaching has power. When you're witnessing to someone, the other party could see that you do it out of love for my soul, but with conviction and courage. Can you imagine when you are witnessing to someone? You know, I don't want you to burn in hell. And the other person asks you, are you sure you're not going to burn in hell? You're like, I don't think so. Okay, and the other person goes, you don't think so? What is that? Is that like 70%, 60%, 80%? That means you have a percentage of chance that you're gonna burn in hell? They'll be like, I don't really wanna listen to you. You have no conviction. However, when you didn't do anything, because Bible says, for by grace are ye saved through faith, and that not of yourself, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Like Ephesians 2, 8 and 9, you receive that as gift, and then you are so thankful. You could actually tell people, I didn't do anything. I'm so thankful, and I want to share that thanksgiving, what God has done for me. I want to share that blessing to you. Then you could have courage, because I didn't do anything. I could tell you boldly that I was just a wretched sinner saved by grace, and I'm still a wretched sinner saved by grace. And I could tell you I didn't have to do anything to receive that salvation. If anybody else tells you to where you have to speak in tongues and do good works to go to heaven, you know, they're against the Bible. It's contrary to the right doctrine. And you'll never have assurance of salvation. As you can see, man, why is courage missing in my life? Just think about it. Why is it that when I'm out there, day-to-day life, whether I'm at school, whether I'm at work, whether I'm at just doing my personal things, why is it that I lack this courage and boldness I read about in the Bible, where I hear about through my brethren? Why? Because you're not thankful enough. You are missing thankfulness in your life. You are this spoiled little children who always asking for more and more and more. Instead of being thankful for everything, instead of being grateful for every, you know, day of life, right? You know, Sister Kathy said, thankful for another day, right? I mean, how many of you guys are thankful that you're here today? How many of you guys are grateful that you have air to breathe, for example? I guarantee you, because I'm of the same. We don't thank God for air that we breathe on a daily basis. I mean, we don't thank God on a daily basis that I could write today. We don't thank God on a daily basis that I could see today, I could hear today, I could taste today. Why? Because you have become so selfish. You have become very, very arrogant person. You're full of pride. You know, pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall. You and I are about to fall because of our pride, because of our arrogance, because of our selfishness, because of our I can do attitude. Right? You know, when you think about it, as a Bible believer, your mindset has to change. You know, world teaches you, you need to have I can do attitude to succeed in life. But as Christians, you gotta have I can do attitude. But I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. You know, as Bob Jones Sr. said, I share this quote a lot, the greatest ability is dependability. When you depend on the Lord instead of your own ability, you're gonna have courage. You're gonna be blessed. When you drive, for those who drive, did you depend on the Lord for His protection? Or were you relying on your ability, thinking that I'm a great driver, you know? And I don't get into accident. I don't get tickets. If I do, it's not my fault, you know? Cop chose the wrong car. Today, I mean, real, I mean, I was coming, taking 10 freeway. I mean, you pray, right? I think you pray to God that for traveling grace and mercy. And the car next to me was speeding up. I don't like to speed that much. I just try to go by the flow of the traffic. And this car was going fast. And right behind it, it was, you know, SUV, white collar. And what do you know, it was Highway Patrol. And the car got him. And what am I trying to say? You always have to you know, be humble and give, you know, all the glory to God. Because if, I guarantee you, because from my experience, if you think that, you know, I'm a good driver, that's why I don't have tickets in my life, that's why I don't get into accident, boom, you're gonna get into accident. Most likely, I'm not saying you're going to, you're gonna get ticket, most likely, because pride has gotten in your way. That's why it is very important for you to check your blessings on a daily basis. Because too many people, when they do not count their blessings, we have, you know, hymns, count your many blessings one by one. What happens? When you don't count your blessings, when you stop counting your blessings, all you're gonna do is start murmuring and complaining about what you don't have. When you're about to murmur, when you're about to complain, think about all the blessings that you have. Let's turn our Bibles to Book of Psalms. Psalms chapter 103. Psalms chapter 103. That's why it's lacking in Christian life, this courage and boldness that you and I should display, especially to this lost world out there. Just like I mentioned, I mean, you want to be light of the world? You got to have boldness and courage. How are you going to do it? Not on your own. You have to have that thanksgiving. Psalms 103. Let's start looking at verse 1. The Bible says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits." Start counting. Start counting all the blessings that you have in your life. "Who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfy thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord executeth righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed." Think about it. I mean, if you're down, you're like, I don't know where to go. You feel like complaining and murmuring. Go to Psalms 103 and start reading it. Think about it. Just start reading it. There are so many things that you can be thankful for in your life. And especially, you know, we saw our textbooks, Apostle Paul. I mean, he had a hard travel, right? He had to travel. I mean, if you study it, man, it's not something that you and I probably could endure. But he thanked God and took courage because some of the brethren came out and encouraged him. And he was able to thank God and give courage. Some of us lack courage and boldness. Why? One of the reasons is because as a brethren, you're being a bad example to other brethren. So they can't take courage. They can't be encouraged. All they can do is they have to put on a sour face just like you. They have to put red blanket or wet blanket on your face, right? Or maybe I saw someone with a red face covering. That's how I said red blanket. But, you know, you become a wet blanket. You're a complainer. Then what happens? When people can thank God and take courage, like Apostle Paul, looking at his brethren, when I look at my brethren, when you look at your brethren, can you thank God and can you take courage? Am I the person who can encourage others, who pray for others, who they can thank God for me and take courage? It just tells you there's great opportunity in your life when it comes to Thanksgiving. It's not just about you being able to be courageous and be bold. As you count your blessings and you see the mighty hand of God in work and being thankful, others can get courage because of you. You know, what's the opposite of courage, right? just the word itself is discourage. A lot of people, when they look at other Christians, they get discouraged. I mean, at the end of the day, it's you and the Lord and personal relationship with you and the Lord. So other people shouldn't be the downfall, and other people shouldn't be an excuse of your, you know, sorry Christian life. Maybe for some of you at this state. However, they play a big role. Imagine, remember for those who are married, right? You come home and your husband is always complaining. Your wife is always complaining. I don't think I'm going to thank God for, oh, thank you, Lord, for giving me a spouse that always complains. I get more courage to go out there and do your ministry because my spouse always complains. I don't think so. Same thing with children. If you're a parent, when you see these children always complaining and murmuring, are you going to go to God, thank you for giving me my son, giving me my daughter who always complains? Man, I love to, when they complain, I would just want to go out there and preach the word. Maybe you do because you're angry, but you know, I want to go out there and, you know, pass out gospel tract, right? No, it discourages you as well. Same thing, right? If you're a parent and kids see that you're always complaining and murmuring about everything, I don't think you got to be praying, thank you, God, for giving me a mother, giving me a father who always complains. They don't complain at the church, outside of, you know, when people could see, but they always complain inside the house, in an intimate setting, always complaining. Thank you, God, that, you know, giving me parents who doesn't complain outside, but who complains at home, you know, covering, you know, less shame. I don't think so. And those people aren't going to be going out there and being courageous. You know what? I want to be a blessing to others. I want to preach the word. I want to read more Bible. I want to pray more because my parents are murmurers and complainers. Maybe you pray that you get out of that situation. However, they themselves are not blessing. Then you look at your life. If I were to ask, if someone were to ask your family members, your close ones, your close friends, your cousins, when they look at your life, can they get encouragement? Are they encouraged? Are they thanking God for you? Or are they instead, you know, ponder, man, when I look at that face, or when I interact with my brother or sister or my parents, my wife or husband or my close friends, man, I get down. You know? There's no courage in me. I'm not thankful. I get more discouraged. That's why each one of you, every single child of God, can make a great difference in God's ministry. Sometimes you forget, like, you know what? I'm just going to live my own life. You know, I don't want to bother anyone, and I don't want anyone to bother me. Whether I'm angry today, discouraged today, shouldn't be something that should influence you or anybody else. It's just me. That's just being, you know, selfish. That's being ignorant. That's being, you know, dumb way of thinking. Again, for some, people don't know doctrine and they're just young babies who's growing up. But for many, you know biblical doctrine, right? We're all one body in Christ. You know? I mention it again, like in unity. I mean, are you going to neglect your big toe if it's hurting? Are you going to neglect your pinky or thumb or your elbow when it's aching? No, you take care of it. And you love to see, you know, for some of you who likes to work out, right? You love to see improvements in your, you know, body, I guess, shape or tone, right? Through workout and stuff, because you care. And when you transfer that, you know, example to your own Christian life, Are you actually encouraging other parts of Christ's body? Right? I don't know about you, right? You know, Sister Kathy just being here, you know, is a great blessing and gives a jolt and gives an opportunity to praise God more. And I'm sure that it's an opportunity that where you could be more courageous, knowing that there's brethren who's praying for me, who encourages me. That's why she could go to God and thank God and take courage in her situation. It could be Pastor Shrive. I mean, how many of you guys have been a blessing to Pastor Shrive? I mean, how many of you guys actually encouraged him? Think about it. We're talking about Apostle Paul here. Apostle Paul. I mean, we always think of him as like the, you know, strongest Christian, right? He's like a robot, you know. He never sins, right? I mean, of course he does, but he's like, he has no emotional up and downs. He's just gonna do God's work, no matter what. However, he's a human being, and you could see. When he saw his brethren come out and greet him and encourage him, he thanked God and took courage. I wonder how many of you guys today can be that brethren who was an encouragement, that brethren who Apostle Paul thanked God for and took courage. I want to be thankful for you because that means that I know that you encourage me, and then I could take more courage. You know, as pastors, preachers, you know, they get most courage when they see the people in the ministry be thankful and go out there and be courageous for the Lord and be an encouragement. As you think about your spiritual state, think about how many times you've complained on a daily basis. Think about what kind of murmur you are. Think about what kind of, you know, blessing, how many people you've encouraged, how many people you greeted in the Lord, how many people you made other people be thankful of you so that they could be courageous in the Lord. There are no excuses. If you care for your own body, you should care for body of Christ, right? If you are a selfish person, get rid of it. Start thinking about others. Get rid of your old nature and old flesh. Let it die on the cross daily. And let the new man work in your life. You know, bear the, you know, fruit of Holy Ghost, right? And as you continue in this, you know, Christian journey, as you count your blessings, as you praise God, you know, and you stop complaining, and then you start cultivating that heart for your brethren and for everyone around you, then what's going to happen? You're going to be that person who's full of courage and boldness, which came from thanksgiving. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, many times and many days, we just become so complacent. We become complainers and murmurs of everything, Lord. I pray that we'll confess our selfishness, pride, and arrogance. I pray that we'll be more thankful, Lord, from A to Z, all parts of our life. And I pray that we could also be that encouraging influence where others can be thankful for you, Lord, and be courageous. We want to be courageous and bold in this wicked world, Lord God. We want to be the light of the world. And we want to lead others to you. We want to keep, you know, clean, pure, and great testimony for you, Lord. In order to do that, Lord, it starts with our heart, and we need to be more thankful, Lord. Help us to examine our heart on a daily basis and be thankful, and in return, be courageous, Lord. I pray that also you be with Pastor Shribe, Lord. We lift him up to you according to your will, Lord God. Please heal him, Lord. We pray that all the administrative stuff will be expedited and approved and resolved as soon as possible. And we pray for Sister Kathy for her upcoming surgery. Be with her and the family. Give her comfort and heal her according to your will. And those who are all under the weather, physical ailments, Lord God, we lift them up to you, Lord. Please be with them. Heal them according to your will, Lord, and give each other and their families comfort as well. Lord God, help us to be found faithful, Lord, and even so come, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, everyone.